With CloudBerry Backup, you can backup files and folders to any popular cloud storage. It has a nice graphical interface for desktop use. There is a command line interface to backup your server. Moreover, you can access CloudBerry Backup remotely through a nice graphical interface. I reviewed the desktop app of CloudBerry Backup for Linux last year. You can watch that video by clicking on this card. There is also the link in the description. In this video, I will show you how to install CloudBerry Backup on the Linux server and how to configure it using the web interface. Let's get started. First, you need to download the installer of CloudBerry Backup for Linux. I provide the link in the description. Although it says trial here, CloudBerry Backup is free for personal use. If you need pro features such as encryption, compression, email support, and high volume to backup, you can get CloudBerry Backup Pro license for a reasonable price. Provide your email and download the installer. Next, upload it to your server. You can also do everything you see in this video locally if you just want to test CloudBerry Backup. Then log in to your server and install it. Now CloudBerry Backup is available at OTP local CloudBerry Backup bin. You can run it from here. To be able to run CloudBerry Backup from anywhere, you can add its path to your bash rc file. Just paste this code at the very end, Ctrl O to save and Ctrl X to exit. Then source bash rc file. Then go back to your home directory and try to launch CloudBerry Backup from there. Now CloudBerry Backup works regardless of where you are. Now let's activate the license. These are the options for license activation. You need to provide the email you used during the download and the license type. I will activate the personal trial license. You can keep using CloudBerry Backup with this command line interface on your server. Or you can use the CloudBerry Lab website where you can find all the necessary commands. But I recommend you to activate the web interface and access your server CloudBerry Backup from your browser with this user-friendly interface. To activate this web interface, run cbb option set web access https on. The web interface is activated. Open the web browser on your local computer and type the address of your server and port 43211. Also, make sure you type HTTPS in front, because sometimes the browser fails to recognize it as a secure connection. It is safe to edit as exception. And this is the login window for CloudBerry Backup. Login with your server username and password, and you can start configuring CloudBerry Backup for Linux on your server with this nice graphical interface instead of reading the documentation and typing all the commands in the command line. To give you an idea of how the web interface works, I will create a backup plan with Amazon S3 storage. You click Create New, give a name to this backup plan. I also recommend activating the block level backup. Block level backup allows you to backup only the modified parts of the file, instead of running a full backup every time a file is changed. So this way, you will save your bandwidth and reduce the backup time. This is one of the unique features of CloudBerry Backup. Next, add a storage account. As you can see, there are many options. I will use Amazon S3. Name this storage location and paste your Amazon keys. You can download your keys from Amazon S3 console by clicking on My Security Credentials, then Access Keys, and Create New Access Keys. Next, you can select an existing bucket from this drop-down menu or create a new one. I will create a new one. I will use the Stockholm location. It was recently added to CloudBerry Backup and it is the closest to my physical location. OK. After you created the storage, select it and proceed. Select what folders to include. I will backup my home. You can also exclude some folders here. For example, I usually exclude cache from all my backups. Here you can add more filters. I usually backup empty folders to keep my home folder structure. Here you can enable compression and encryption. There are also some storage dependent settings like Amazon S3 here. Be careful because some of these non-default options like Amazon S3 transfer acceleration may cost you some extra fee. Next, define how many backups you want to create and for how long to keep them. Define the schedule of the block level backup and the full level backup. CloudBerry Lab recommends making a full backup from time to time, so everything will be backed up, not only the differences as during the block level backup. This ensures the integrity of your backup data. Finally, activate the email notification. I think this is essential for a server user. In the latest version of CloudBerry Backup, you can also request a full backup report. Check the summary and run the backup. After the backup has finished, you can see the summary here in the web interface, in your email. You can also access the details report from this email. And you can, of course, check all the backup files in your cloud storage. Here is my Amazon CloudBerry backup bucket and the backed up files. Everything else you see in this web interface is similar to what would you see on the desktop app I reviewed previously. So for more details, watch the video where I created a backup and restore plan with Google Cloud Storage and reviewed all the settings of CloudBerry Backup for Linux desktop app. You should see that video on your screen right now. Thank you for watching!